work out, but we will see.
As he hits to start off with that 30 cal bike, then he'll move on to 20 burpee box jump overs, and then finish with 10 heavy sandbags over the shoulder.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Look out lanes 2, 3.
Hey, Lou.
And 8 are the most important for qualifying for the games. Again, 2, 3, and 8.
Kayla.
Here we go. 30 cows on the assault bike.
I expect all of these guys to be off under 45 seconds, if not less than 35 seconds. You can see the hands, the feet are flying. They're driving those handles with everything they have.
And of course,
it's the last one.
Very important. You do have to remember the other teams have gone. Marco Coppola, a 309.25.
He's got to get it. There's Tommy.
Time
by Marco Coppola could matter a lot to them right now. Hopefully they took a look at it and know what they have to chase down.
Easy Muhammad, Joseph Kester, and it's Tommy Venus, who are your top three, and Venus wearing those green shorts that caught on top.
No surprise seeing Kester out front last year at the 2016 games, and they had that 100% workout to close out Friday. 40 box jump over, 30 D-ball cleans. He finished the best out of all the finishers from the South Regional, so I expect him to do well here right now.
Venus is leading Sean Sweeney. Sweeney the third for the bottom, and Venus in his black shorts on the right side, again with that cutoff shirt, doing what he needs. He's holding on to that final spot, 366 points against Sweeney and Moran at 346. Here is the bubble. Venus again, a 20-point advantage. Venus also ahead of Zachary Moran and the strike shorts now, second from the top. So Venus staying ahead of the two men who were chasing him.
Even Sweeney admitted he's not too explosive, and this is not his best event. However, I'll tell you right now, end of the weekend, with the chance he has to go back, he's giving this everything he has, weakness or strength.
Here's Sean Sweeney, and there is Venus again. Venus on the right side, Sweeney on the left side. Venus, one segment ahead, so that's anywhere from 1 to 4 reps ahead. Zachary Moran, same thing with Sweeney, as Moran pulls into the same segment with 4 reps. There is Moran with the American flag shorts, and Venus is off. Venus making his way. He is 10 reps away. 10 reps, and then a sandbag carrier, lane number 1, Joseph Kester, trying to go out with a bang and trying to get it.
He's got it. He's got it. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Get it. Get it. Get it, Tommy. Get it.
Venus is punching his ticket up to Madison for his first games trip at 20 years old.
Easy Muhammad has pulled even. And now it's going to be Kester remaining in first place, followed by Venus and Easy Muhammad. Easy Muhammad doing everything he needs to do to go to Madison, Wisconsin.
Easy going for that touch-and-go rep there.
Kester maintains a 2-rep lead on Venus as he will bring it in to the next segment. Here's Easy. So Kester, Venus, and Muhammad, your top three.
As nasty as that touch-and-go rep might be, it's probably the best choice here. Then you don't have to make that decision to leave the bag on the ground or pick it up again. It's already in your hands.
2 reps for Kester to win the heat. Looks like that 309 may hold up. He's got 4 seconds to pick it up and get across. Looks like it'll be a little bit off of Coppola's time. It's going to be close. But a nice job by Kester to finish out the weekend.
What did he make?
Yeah, he's going! Oh. Yeah!
He looks excited for that world.
That is so cool.
Yes!
Oh my god.
Boy, Venus is fired up. Lane number 9. Look like Brandon Luckett is in. Travis Williams has a finish. There's Logan Collins, who has completed it, but it looks like Venus has held off the two men that were closest because they are still out on the floor.
Amazing weekend for Brandon Luckett as well, 22 years old, regional debut right here. Pretty amazing weekend for the young guys.
Moran lost the sandbag and collapses. He's still got to roll that onto the finish mat, and there it is. He is now complete. Venus had a 0 machine CrossFit in Phoenix, Arizona. Boy, he is fired up. He knows he beat the two men close to them, Sweeney and Moran. Joseph Kester, really nice finish there. Goes out with a bang. He won't qualify
body. Gets a second place overall at 310.95. So he was just a fraction over a second off.
He's fired up, man.
Mm-hmm. Lane number 6, Dakota Rager, and Roy Rager put on a show. Wiley seemed to always be there. Oh, someone finished first. And
yeah, he should be. Oh, Rager was there. Two guys were chasing him. He beat him.
Talks back kind of a Tia Claire Toomey performance. Just very consistent in the top five all weekend.
Two event wins as he heads closed out Sunday here. That might even be his worst finish. Really amazing job by him.
Again, nothing is official until we get the results from the judges or the scoring staff. But on the Naked Eye, unless something happened, they've got to go back and look at it. Tommy Venus should have secured that top five.
No surprise either that he was going to do well in that event with his strength numbers and how he's performed elsewhere in the weekend. Not surprised he was able to hold off Moran and Sweeney to get that trip to the games.
Wow.
Joseph Gesser gets the heat win.
Like we said, you know, with his performance last year at the games, with 100%, no surprise of his capacity to sprint, go
cool.
fast, go hard. He was able to touch
him. He worked hard. He's
gains,
grown up.
Which I think was kind
he's,
of the key to victory.
He's matured quite a bit.
With Marco Coppola, he really pushed through that fast. Nice little second place event placing there to end out the weekend for Gesser.
Again, he'll finish in the top 10. We'll see how far he moves up the standings, but there is Venus again. Nothing is official until it is announced down on the competition floor, but he was pretty fired up about it.
He seemed really confident there. He came out hot off of that assault bike, pushed hard through the burpee box of overs, but like most of the races that have been decided in this event, he pulled ahead and finished strong on those sandbag cleans. And there we see him. Maybe we don't know it yet, but he seems pretty confident that he's going to Madison. I don't know why he'd be that excited.
Josh Bridges has some good celebrations. Tommy Venus is pretty good there. He has every right to be as well.
I thought he might redo the workout.
This is just the event results here. We don't have the final weekend results yet, but Coppola hangs on to the event win by
wow.
second and a half over
he took third. He's going. He took third overall in that final heat, or in that event six. That's amazing. Dude, he executed big time.
Now if he can make it back next year, he knows how this goes.
Absolutely. And like, you know,
wow.
faces here in the South region.
Job, Tommy.
For themselves, if they continue to stay
holy
at it,
cow.
Be threats for years to come, and that's always really nice to see.
Sean Sweeney, the look on his face, knows he made a great, great charge, but unfortunately, in this day and age of the CrossFit Regionals, not only consistency, but it's got to be high consistency, and a 44th place finish just knocked him down. He has a mid-pack finish of that, maybe going to the games, but hindsight 2020, went at it with maybe the right attitude. He put it on social media Friday night. He's like, look, I'm not going to dwell on it. I'm not going to blame anyone. I can only control the next four events.
And I don't think there was anyone else who could have made such an incredible push to try and squeeze his way back into that fifth spot. But that 44th is that piece that's going to hold him back there. And I think what's frustrating about this as an athlete is he looks at it and he's like, you know what, that doesn't reflect my fitness. That was an error of judgment in the moment. And that's a hard way to end your season. You know, everyone would rather have it be, hey, I died on the stake. It wasn't that, overlooked something. That's always the worst part there. But amazing guy to keep his head up throughout that and fight harder than I think anyone else here could have for that fifth spot.
You know, you can see an easy Bahamut performance out of Sweeney next year. Easy missed it barely last year on that rope climb event after making the games the year before in his debut. I'd watch for Sean Sweeney next year in the 2018 race.